Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to my new tutorial looking at how to choose and use supplementary lenses for close-up photography, whether you're using bridge cameras, compact systems cameras or even full-frame cameras. Now, I have produced a guide which goes along with the series and it will be free to download from my download section of my photographic blog, and I'll put a link to that in the video description below. Lots of information about lenses in general, but in particular some of the maths behind using and choosing the supplementary lenses and how they work and how magnification is calculated, etc. So if you want to download that and follow it along with the video, again that link will be in the video description below. And don't forget, if you're a new viewer to the channel and you're liking what you see, please do hit that subscribe button and the like button, and you'll be notified when I upload new videos in this series. So I appreciate if you would do that. So looking at supplementary lenses for your camera. Now, I've said, does your camera need glasses? And to show you what I mean, here's a pair of ordinary reading spectacles. These are number one diopter. You get them in various strengths, obviously, but my prescription is plus one for reading. So here we have a plus one lens that has been mounted on a step down ring so I can attach it to my camera. And you can see the effect that we will get. Looking at the picture above, of these four little fellas from Legoland, you can see the width of view we've got with just the lens, and it's the 150mm lens on the Canon EOS M5, I think I've got that at the moment. So that is as it is now. Lens onto the camera, we'll go back to the overhead camera and I'll refocus, manual focus, and you can see we've got a magnified view, and that's at exactly the same working distance. So the camera's got the same working distance, but by using that number one diopter, you can see we've got an enlarged view. If we increase the strength of that diopter, we can reduce the working distance between the lens and the subject and get higher magnification. Now remember, when we use a supplementary lens, these are positive value lenses. They are plus value diopters. So that means they reduce the actual focal length of the lens to which they're attached. If you start with a 24mm lens on your camera and you attach a number 3 diopter, working out the maths, you'll find that you end up with a focal length of 23mm. The effect of these diopters on the wider focal lens isn't as great as using them with the telephoto set. These supplementary lenses really come into their own with cameras with large zoom ratio. So for example, this FZ80 or 82 camera has a x60 zoom. If we're going to be using it at something like 600mm equivalent focal length, so we can isolate our subject against a background or give us working distance so we can photograph butterflies, insects, etc., then by using a supplementary lens, we can increase the magnification that we get at that same working distance, or we can reduce the working distance to get us closer to the subject and hence give us more magnification. And all that is again explained in this guide if you want to follow along with my maths of how you can actually achieve the magnification you want and the image size that you want. Now, these supplementary lenses are normally available in single element for various lens diameters. I've got a set here which are 62mm. It's a number 1, a number 2 and a number 4. Some sets you can get a number 10 diopter, which really is not worth buying. They do give tremendous color fringing or chromatic aberration, and the outside edges of the image are not really sharp. So number 1, number 2 and number 4 are the ones that I particularly recommend. So you can try them, find out which one you use most frequently, and then purchase something like an achromatic lens which doesn't have any chromatic aberration and gives you much sharper images center to edge than you'll get with a single element. This one is a close-up 250D, so that's the equivalent of a number 4 diopter. Now you can work out what the focal length of your lens is by dividing 1000 by the diopter number. So in this case it's a number 4, so if we divide 1000 by 4 we end up with a 250mm focal length. If we were to use a number 2 diopter, again divide 1000 by 2 and you've got a 500mm effective focal length. And if you had a number 1 lens, divide that 1000 by 1 and you end up with a 1000mm focal length. And that becomes the actual focus distance, if you've got the camera set to infinity, then that will give you the focal distance. So if you had a number two lens, when you've got your camera focused to infinity, the actual center plane to your subject will be 500 millimeters. If you had a number four, that distance would be 250 millimeters. Now, there's no reason why you can go into somewhere like Poundland or your thrift store and look at the reading glasses there, find the diopters, one, one and a half, two, whatever, and use your camera to find out what the focus distance is with the zoom lens that you've got on board. So you say, I wanted 200 millimeters, I'll just set this to 200 millimeters, hold the lens in front of that lens, and then find out what my working distance would be. If that's sufficient for your needs, then you could purchase the right lens with the correct size of filter, etc. So let me change this spectacle lens to a number two lens, and we'll have a look at the closer working distance. So you can see now that I've changed the spectacle lens to the number two close-up lens. My working distance now is about 55 centimeters. I was around about 70 centimeters with the number one lens. So we can see the reduced working distance, and you can see the magnification now of these characters with the number two lens. If I was to change to a number four, then again I'd reduce that working distance and increase the magnification. So let me do that for you. So I've now changed to that number four supplementary lens, kept the lens exactly the same, 150 millimeters focal length, and you can see that I'm going to have to move this quite close to the subject to enable it to focus at that distance. So you can see the image size that you get using number four and the 150 millimeter focal length. If I reduce the focal length of the lens, then you can see you can get the image magnification with a closer working range. So we're now working with a much shorter working distance with that lens than is natively possible with the lens itself. So you can get much closer for giving you much bigger image magnification with this sort of setup. Now, the most popular of these close-up lenses is in fact the Raynox lens. It's available as the 150 or 250. The 150 has something like a 4-diopter, and the 250 has got a 5-diopter, so quite strong lenses. I would always recommend new users would start with the 150 lens, and that gives you some great images. It's a spring-loaded clip and will accommodate most lens sizes, but with this type of lens I do recommend you use a step-down ring from the lens size to here. If you're using something like the 52mm f/200 or the 55mm f/300, then a 55 to 43mm is necessary to give you the right amount of fixture. You will need to zoom into something like x3 to overcome the vignetting, or use the C conversion of the setup to enable you to get to that magnification, beyond which you'll get some great images. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you found that useful, and of course you'll find that link to the booklet in the video description below. So until the next video, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in future videos. Goodbye for now.